Hi, welcome back to Element 14 Presents. I'm Katie, and in today's episode, I'm going to be making a bike speedometer.
Amazing hacks. Inspired designs. Each week, Element 14 Presents brings you innovative projects using electronics, engineering, and more.
So recently, I've got my push bike out for the first time in about 10 years. Government actually did a scheme where they would pay to get any bike serviced and back on the road to try to get people out on their bikes. So I took them up on that. It has been waiting for a long time to get the gears fixed and I've not had time to do it. So I took advantage of getting someone else to do it for free. So now it's all working. I went to get on it. It had the bike speedometer sensor on the wheel, but the display unit is nowhere to be seen. Who knows where that's gone in the last 10 years. So I was thinking, oh, I have to buy a new one. It's quite nice to know how fast you're riding. And then I thought, why not make one? So in today's episode, I'm going to be making myself a little speedometer to go on the handlebars of my bike. Let's have a look at how I'm going to do it. The speedometer that was on my bike already was wired to the front forks, and then there was a magnet on the spokes, and then every time the wheel did a revolution, it would look at how far up the spokes. I think you had to type in how far up the spokes it was and what size wheel it was, and it would work out how far your wheel had gone around in one rotation. And then it would work out your distance and your speed. So I thought about that, and then I thought, actually, a GPS module is really easy to get and really easy to get that data out of. I'm going to be outside when I'm riding, so I shouldn't have too much problem with picking up the GPS signal without any external antenna. So I'm going to go ahead with that approach. So I've made myself this quick overview of what stages I'm going to have. So I'm going to have the GPS in to a controller. That's going to be also powered by a battery pack, and it will output speed and the distance you've traveled on a screen. So I'm going to have a look and see what the best parts are for each of these stages of the system. My parts have all arrived, so let's take a look at what I've ordered. The parts I'm going to use in this project is the Arduino Nano. This is going to be the controller. I've then got this GPS 3 click board. This can connect to the Arduino and give us the GPS data. My screen is going to be this nice little 4D Systems circular LCD with touch. The power supply is going to be this power bank, because it will be really quick and easy to just connect it up to the Arduino and power everything, and really easy to carry on the bike. And the enclosure for all of this is going to be a combination of a silver 3D printed case for the screen, and using the case that I've already got that mounts onto my bike frame to house the controller and the battery. This is a sort of semi-hard case. So now I've got all that, let's get started putting the project together. So the circuit for this is going to be fairly straightforward. We've got the Arduino Nano 33, we've got the GPS 3 clickboard, I've got the header connector for the screen, and I've got two buttons. So the GPS and the screen both connect on RX and TX for serial comms to the Nano 33. The buttons are down to ground. One's momentary and the other is a positional switch. The momentary one, when you press, it will look at that and reset the distance you've travelled, so you can reset it mid-ride without resetting the whole device. And the other one is a positional one, so when you put it on, it's to show that British summer time is in force and it will add an hour onto the time, and when you flick it in the other direction that will come off. I'm not sure if every country has a summertime time change, so you might not need that, but in the UK our times switch by an hour for half the year. So I'm going to put this on some breadboard and we can check it's all working, and then I'll move it across to stripboard. So the 4D system screen I'm using has a program called Workshop 4 that you can run. Now this program will let you drag and drop elements to be programmed to the screen, and then you can just change the values displayed by those elements by sending serial comms across from the Arduino. So that's what I'm doing. I've set up this display to have a gauge around the outside to show the current speed, and set it just to be a little arrow to display where on that your speed currently is. I've then got a static bit of text saying distance above here, and these values will show how far you've gone. I'm never expecting to go above 30 miles an hour or 99.99 miles. If you think you might, you may need to adjust those. I've then got this little LED element that will show red if you've not got a GPS fix, and go to black when you have. So I'll just know that if that's showing red, I can't trust any of the information it's giving me. The distance isn't going to be updating. And then down here, this element here will display the current time. So in here, I can click on object and it will give me the name for each of the objects. So I need to keep a record of these so I know what to send over on the Arduino code so it can adjust correctly. So now I've got all that ready, I'm going to go into the Arduino IDE and program the display to show the data from the GPS unit. So this is the code for the Arduino. I'm making an extra serial port on pins 5 and 6. This is because I need a serial comms for the GPS unit and for the screen. I'm doing all the rest of the setup. And then our main loop's quite simple. It's checking if I want to reset the current distance. So that will just reset distance to zero if we press that button. So that's just so we can reset how far we've travelled mid-journey without having to power cycle the Arduino. And then once every second, I'm going to take the current hour and minute, adjust that by British summer time if I've set the British summer time switch to active. So in the UK, that just adds an hour to the time. And then we're taking the speed from the GPS is in knots. I'm adjusting that here to make it miles per hour, and then I'm looking at that miles per hour, adjusting it to see how far we're going to travel in a second, and then add that to the previous distance, so every second we're adding on how far we'll have traveled in that second, which will give us a rough distance, but I'm happy with what that's going to give me. I'm timesing it by 10,000 there, so it's not so small that it loses the precision of it, because I want to display it in miles with two decimal places. So back when I display it to the screen, I'm going to have to adjust for that again. And then down here, I'm just taking the current time. If the time has changed, because we're only displaying minutes, it only needs to update when the minute changes. It's going to write the time to the screen, and then we're going to write the current speed to the meter on the screen, and the distance divided again by that 100 to the object for the distance. So that's all the code. I'm going to send that to the Arduino, check it's all working, and then if it is, I can look at doing a case design and assembling it all up. So I've made the circuit on this piece of breadboard, just connected this circuit to the power bank that I'm going to be using when it's on my bike. Everything's connected. The screen shows the display that we programmed into it by default. The time is updating from the GPS. I've checked the BST switch. So with the switch on GMT 1106, flick it to BST, reset, and it will update to 1206. I'm going to put this circuit onto strip board, and I'm going to have a look at the design for a case for our screen.
Do you like free stuff? You can join the road test program. You can get free dev kits, test equipment, and even online training courses. In exchange for a detailed review, join our road test program. Learn more at the link below. Ah, free stuff.
So for the case design, I've picked FreeCAD for this one. So I've made this to hold just the display, and then I'm going to put the Arduino and the GPS unit in a bag on the bike frame. This is to reduce how much I've got on the handlebars of the bike, because it's quite a vulnerable position. So this is in three parts. So this is the top part. The screen will sit in this recess in the inside here, and then this top part will fit over this main part. So the screen has an adapter board that it plugs into, so that will fit in this recess here, and then I'm going to wire it off to the Arduino, so the wire will come out of this hole here. I've made some positions for the bolts to fit into, and the back of the screen will fit in this hole here. The underside of this has the profile for my handlebars, so the handlebar will fit in there, and then there is a clip section which the bolts will come through, and I've got some wing nuts that will let me put this on and off quite quickly and easily. So this part will just bolt onto here. I've removed a couple mil just so that there's some space to clamp it down to make it nice and secure to the handlebars. So that's my case. Now I've ordered some quite nice cosmic filament, which has a metal flake in it. So I'm hoping it will be nice and shiny and look quite smart. So I'm going to send this to the printer and we can see how it comes out. So the 3D printed parts are all off the printer. We've got those three parts and the nuts and bolts to attach it to the bike frame. The circuit is all on strip board now. So I'm going to assemble all that together with the bike frame case and the screen and the power bank. And here's it. All assembled. I've got enough of GPS fix that it's showing the time, but not enough that the indicator's off to show that it's showing speed and distance. But that's because I'm inside and I'm not moving, so it won't show any speed anyway. I've got the bag to Velcro onto the bike frame, and this will just clamp on to my handlebars so I can take it outside and try it on the bike. So I'm really pleased with how this has come out. It's really useful. It looks good. It fits in quite nicely on the bike. It's really convenient that you can just unstrap it and clip it on and off. Because of that, you can put it on any bike at all. So that's really handy. I'm really pleased. I changed my original plan for the Molex connector to the 4-pole 3.5mm jack. That made it really, really easy just to plug the screen in and disconnect it, so I can remove this part or this part from the bike quickly. Probably remove this when I'm traveling, but the actual screen will be left on the bike, so that's really handy. So I've got that extra functionality of the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on that Arduino. I'd mainly gone for that Arduino because it was what's in stock, but having that, I think I might add in the future the ability to dump the distance and the max speed and maybe the average speed off into a log, and then I'll be able to track journeys. So that'd be really handy. Because it's all separate, it'd be really easy to actually use it on other devices, other vehicles. So you could put it on a scooter or on a motorbike or anything. It's really portable, so that's really handy. If you think you'd use it on something different to a bike, why don't you let me know on the Element 14 community at element14.com/presents. I'd be interested if you can think of another use for it. But yeah, I'm going to go off and do some bike riding. So I'll see you next time. Cheers.